how to become a full stack developer. If you are someone sitting here watching this video and you've Googled this, I can guarantee one of your first thoughts that came to mind is, there is a lot of information out there, where do I start? I can guarantee this because I have been there as someone who has been a full stack developer for almost 5 years now. When I started out my self-learning journey, ended up going to a coding bootcamp, but at first I was like, where do I start? There is so much information out there. How do you know what is good information, what is bad? Do I need a certificate? Do I need, what do I need? You get what I'm saying. In this video, I am going to break down for you what exactly is a full stack developer and how to become one. Before we can get really into how to become a full stack developer, we need to understand just exactly what is a full stack developer. Well, to answer that question first, let's go to our trusty friend Google, who knows all. Do they? I don't know. As a developer, you always think Google knows all. According to Google, the first thing that comes up for me is full stack developers straddle two separate web development domains, the front end and the back end. Front end includes, of course, the client side or site viewer and anything that a user can interact with. And then, of course, by contrast, the back end is the servers, databases, and other architecture. So that sounds like a lot. Is it even possible nowadays to become a full stack developer? And this term full stack developer has really gotten carried away. Some people say no one is even possible. It's not even possible to become a full stack developer. And I really think it is, because I really think the term really refers to both the front and back end side of things. When people start saying full stack developer means that you're also doing DevOps or that you're also doing QA, I think that's taking it a little too far and we're going into other roles. Today we are going to break it up into two sections. Let's talk about the front end and then let's talk about the back end. Okay, let's go. And in this video, I'm going to be reviewing the two meta courses around front end and back end development. These are two courses, two programs that you can take and go through, which will really equip you for front end and then also back end. So if you take both of them, of course, we get a full stack. One of the things that really stood out to me about each of these courses is when you are complete one of them, so say you have completed the front end course, you will actually have exclusive access to the Meta Career Program's job board. So this is really a job search platform that connects you with over 200 plus employers who have committed to sourcing talent through Meta's certificate programs. So I think it's a kind of win-win situation. One hand, you are learning and growing. And then on the other hand, once you complete the course, you actually get to utilize that to network and meet other people. And I've never seen anything like this before, so I think it's really cool that they have really combined both the education side of things and then the networking side of things. Because really, if you want to get a job and you're an amazing developer, amazing front-end developer, but you don't have the right network or right connections, it's going to be really difficult. Okay, let's just dive into what is really required in a front-end developer or as a front-end developer. Well, of course, let's start with the basics. We gotta know HTML. I know it's not the most exciting thing for people to learn and they want to jump right to JavaScript, but HTML is something that you need to learn, and I would say learn first. Alongside with HTML, of course, is CSS, equally as important. And as I mentioned, you might want to skip through these or just power through so you can focus on JavaScript or a framework, but at the end of the day, you need to have a strong foundation before you start going to the next step. After though, you have a strong understanding of both HTML and CSS, we can move on to the exciting stuff, which is JavaScript. Exciting, but also, if you were to ask me when I was learning it, it would be more like terrifying. But this course really helps you walk through it and get a deep understanding as to the basics of JavaScript and carries you on into becoming an expert in it. Now, with a front-end developer, you are not necessarily, if you're just focusing on front-end, you don't need to be a designer or familiar with the back-end per se, but having an understanding of how these kind of different roles work, I think is really important. And I like in this course, you actually get to learn Figma, and that's a tool that a lot of designers use. So if it's something that, as a front-end developer, you become accustomed to and familiar with, it will really help you when you are speaking to designers. It will help you with the language, or maybe they send you just different mock-ups of their designs through Figma and you will be using Figma. It's something that I didn't learn until I actually started working in the industry how to use it, and it's one of those things that I don't see a lot of different either courses, boot camps, programs, whatever the case may be, teaching it, and this really stood out to me that they really highlight that and teach that. Alongside that, of course, the ever-loved, very in-demand React. I'm a React girl at heart, so I'm very happy they focus on React. And then also Bootstrap. I think one of the most important things, though, if you are a front-end or back-end developer that does not get spoken about enough, we always talk about the JavaScript, the React, all the coding parts of it, but we don't really speak enough about the version control. Learning Git, learning how to utilize version control, content management systems is so important. And once again, when I was learning how to code at first, it's something I really skimmed over. And then in turn, when I had my first developer job, I really had trouble with it. It was a whole thing. So I was so scared of it at that time. And even using the terminal or anything like that, I was like, this is so strange to me. So the fact that if you can pick up Git and version control right from the get-go, you will really stand out, I think, especially when you're looking for, you know, your first or second job as a developer. And in this course, you will learn GitHub repositories for version control, content management systems, and also how to edit images going back into Figma. Now, let's talk about money. Let's talk about what is an average salary or total compensation for a front-end developer. Well, for this, let's go to my favorite website. If you know me, you've seen some of my videos, you know where we are going, which is Levels FYI. I'm going to it literally right now, real time, people. Okay, let's go. Salaries by title. We are going to go to, what do we have here? We have for options, we have full stack. No, we want front end, come on. Maybe they don't have front end. Web development front end. Okay. So when I Google, and this is just, once again, this can really vary based on location, experience, so many different things, but web development, front end, we're looking at a median total compensation package around 142,000 US. So this, once again, can vary greatly, way up, down, depending on where you're located. But it's a great salary, a great total compensation, especially if you are someone who loves doing the front end work of things, seeing things come to life or animations come to life with JavaScript. That was one of my favorite things. And it's such a job that you can really grow into. With front end development and also back end development, there are so many ways that you can really structure your career. For example, if you start out as a front end developer, you can really grow it into becoming a dev lead, where you lead a bunch of developers, to a manager, to an architect, to there's just a project manager. The possibilities are endless. You can continue down strictly front-end, become a senior front-end developer, and so on. And I think that's one of the best things for me that I love about coding and tech in general, is the possibilities are really whatever you put on yourself. Whatever you want to do, however you want to grow your career, you can do that. Okay, I feel like that gives us a good understanding as what a front-end developer is, what is required. And once again, if we have a checklist, it's JavaScript, HTML, CSS, learning a library or a framework like React, learning version control, learning, what else did we say? I think that covers it all. Figma, content management systems. That's kind of it in a nutshell. No big deal, you know? It's okay. But no, with this course, I think it's a really great way to check off all of those boxes. And also too, what I like is at the end of the course, closer to the end of it, you will actually build a real world project. So this gives you a project that you can put into your portfolio. Let's talk about backend. Last but not least, I feel like you're hearing all my horrible sayings. Last but not least, backend development, when I started my career, was the direction I wanted to go. And if I'm being really honest with you, the main reason I wanted to become a backend developer versus a frontend is because at the time, backend sounded cooler. And I don't know if that's still true today. I do both now. I started out as a backend, then moved to frontend, and I really like them both, but definitely have done more frontend as of recent. So I guess that's where I'm landing right now. Backend is a great way for anyone who really is interested in architecture and learning more about the systems. And with this backend course through Meta, it will actually teach you how to do the Python syntax, which is really the most popular choice when it comes to machine learning, data science, and artificial intelligence. So Python is one of those languages that you can use it for so many different things in your career that even if you start out as, say, a backend developer and you want to go into machine learning or AI, you will have the knowledge of that programming language to move it over to do that. Actually, leave it like that. And this is a 10-course program put on by Meta, of course, again. And it will teach you in-demand programming skills. It will really walk you through how to solve different coding problems. Not just how to solve, but how to think as a backend developer. And I think that's really important to highlight because oftentimes it's easy to learn something new. We can do that, we can all do that. But to train our mind to really think in a different way, that is another skill in itself. And I really like that they put focus on that as to how to solve problems. And similar to frontend, there will also be Git repositories, version control, and Linux commands. So what does a backend really consist of? Well, as we know, we are speaking about a very popular programming language, Python. We need to know a database. And in this program, they teach MySQL. Of course, there is MySQL, NoSQL, and right now they are focusing on MySQL in this course. They also talk about how to craft and really develop SQL queries, which is super important. And one of my favorite things to do when I was learning SQL, I was like, this is so fun because it's kind of like English, but in a secret code kind of way. You feel kind of like covert, but it's pretty simple to pick up. The other thing they talk about in this course is Django, which of course is the most popular web framework for Python. And also though, I like how they really focus on how the front end consumes APIs. So as a backend developer, it's important for you to understand how the front end works to some degree. Of course, if you are becoming a full stack developer and doing both of these courses, it's kind of one of the ways to put the puzzle pieces together. And then similar to the front end course, this one as well focuses on how to prepare for technical interviews and roles, whether it be front end or back end. And I love that they talk about the interview portion of this. And as it's put on by Meta, one of the top tech companies, one of the MANG companies, it's definitely going to give you insight as to what these companies really look for during technical interviews. Similar to the front-end course as well, there is a community and network that you can join after you complete this course of, once again, over 200 plus employers who have committed to finding talent, sourcing talent through Meta certificate programs. So it also opens up a world, a gates of opportunity for you. I think at the end of the day, so many people get caught up on the specific programming language to learn. Should I focus on front-end or back-end? They almost become frozen and don't just take a jump, just jump into it. And that's why I really wanted to speak about these two courses today, because one of the most popular questions I get is, what course should I take, Tiff? I don't know, there's so many out there. Going back to the beginning of this video, where to start? And these two courses are places that I would start if I was to do it all over again. It's something that you can do on your own time, at home, but have come out of it with so much knowledge and a network. I link them both down below, so make sure to check them out. Thank you all for watching this video. I hope you found it valuable in understanding both the front end and also back end side of things. And I will see you all soon. Thanks, everyone.